And here, welcome you all. This is chapter number 10, 12th standard A section, Python classes and objects. We already discussed in 9 chapters. This is 10th one, Python classes and objects. In last class, we are already discussed about in this introduction and what is class and what is object and how can we create class and what is called object oriented things. And how can we create object, what are the syntax, and these things were already discussed in the last video. Now we are continuing with this. The chapter is topic is class method. We already said, we already give a clear information intimation to thee what is class and what is inside of the class. We have data and functions. These two things are have inside the class, we can create inside the program of class. So using the variables, the exact meaning of data is variables inside the program. And functions, function is also called methods. Functions, we have a collection of statements to fulfill the specific task, particular task. So, the concept of function is, when we are used inside the class, that function is called method. Those variables are called data. So, specifically in the class, data members and member functions. And specifically the member functions is called methods. Here we are seeing the example of class method. Method is just like function, the same thing of function. So the statement defined inside the class must be properly indented. The main rules and regulation of Python is the indentation is properly follow each and every one of the statement. If we need to maintain a block of statement, means that particular indentation is very much important to maintain, then only that individual statements are called as a block. The interpreter will consider as a block of statements. So instead of the methods, we need to maintain the indentation. Here we have maintained this indentation. It's a class name, and this is the data members, that means variables we are creating. So this mark 1, mark 2, mark 3, these are the members of class. Then only we are maintaining this indentation. Interpreter will consider this kind of indentation we are maintaining. Then only interpreter will consider these are the block of this student class, right? And here this program is simply we are adding some numbers and we just get the find the average of the given numbers. Just concept is just like that. And what is we are going to hear using methods, how the methods we are using inside the class, that means function. So first of all, creating the class, the name is student, and we are create mark 1, mark 2, mark 3 as a variables, that means data, and consequently we are given the values of each and every one of the variable. 45 is mark 1, 97 is going to mark 2, and 71 is going to mark 3. And here we are starts with the function process. Def means we are making, this is a keyword, we are starting to define the function. So here we are trying to define the function with the help of self. That means we are called here the process function, and automatically it will be working with the help of self. And here some variable is there, it is also a variable. And here student.mark1, student.mark2, student.mark3. So student is the class name, and dot is the, already last class I said what is meaning of this dot, membership operator. Using this membership operator we are called the members of the class. So here we are calling the these variables with the help of class. And here just the formula, it's a normal one. We know the this what is the purpose we are using here.
and the two print statement is there. One is for display the sum of the values, another one is display the average of the given value. So we are divide with the three. So we can get the, and how the statement will be print, total marks equal to sum and average marks is equal to these two statements. Just like that, what it is there, it will be printed and gets a value in the memory for the sum, and the value is there in the memory average, that is printed here. See one thing, the program is when started, the program is not executed from here onwards. See one thing, directly the controller, that means interpreter, is come to here only. That will be not started here. Started here only. S equal to S is one of the variable. Student is the class name. So the class name student, we are creating object. Just reminded, we are creating normal variable, but here we are create for the class, so that this is called object creation for the student. And then we are call the process statement, process function with the help of S. So the control when comes here, first starting here and then comes here, then the control is going to here because of starts the function. Control will be going to exactly here, the function process. After that, continue the execution here. Whenever the variable is reached, the proper usage of variable is there, the interpreter will be cross check each and every stage. So this is the sequence of execution of this program and functions. And the when the execution, when the control is comes here, the return statement is, what is the purpose of return statement? Just the interpreter terminate the execution at here. The interpreter will goes to where the control is comes, that redirection will get place with the help of filter, and that's the procedure of the things of class methods. And here, thank you once again.